Okay, so we're on Mount Amos, which is on the east coast of Tasmania, and is part of Freycinet National Park. Came up here with the expectation of shooting a nice sunset, and I think the clouds are making an end to that quite quickly. Check it out, like, there's this big bank of clouds. Wasn't supposed to be there, but you know, that's what the weather will do. Yeah, I was expecting high cloud tonight, but there's a big bank over there that's, you know, not going to catch any of those beautiful high clouds that are above me. But that's all right. It's really nice up here. You know, check it out. Like, just have a quick look at this place. Pretty bloody special. Now you can see all the way over to Mount Freycinet. You can see Maria Island down in the haze. You've got Wineglass Bay right in front of us. Okay, so not quite sure I'll be able to talk much about how to capture nice light tonight. That's probably just not going to happen. But what I can do instead is tell you about how I went about finding a photo here, because this is too heavy. Hold up, I'm going to put the tripod down. That's better. Okay, so I thought what I'd talk about today is how I go about finding a composition. You know, it's what we're all here for. And in a landscape like this, the first thing I start thinking about is, what do I want to include, right? Like, what's the whole scenery about? And I think, you know, I'm at elevation. There's this beautiful, massive peninsula in front of me. Obviously, that's going to be sort of the larger frame, the larger element. It's what people come up here to see. That's why I'm up here. It's what I want to see. So that's what I want to capture in the picture. But obviously, the peninsula is huge, and I want to get as much as possible of that into the frame, which means I'm going to be shooting on a 16 to 35, probably somewhere between 16 and 20 mils. And that means I need to find a nice bit of foreground. And foreground is always a bit of a tricky thing. When the light is good, the light can help you a lot with finding nice foreground, because if it comes in from the side, it just creates contrast and like accentuates ridges and so on, which just offer themselves wonderfully to draw your attention to, and then think, well, there actually is something here on the ground that I can, you know, capture as an interesting foreground element, a foreground subject. And that's what I've done here. So, I mean, I'll show you in a second, but if you look around here, this place is just scattered with boulders. Boulders and bushes, little white flowers that are quite nice, all sort of things that can work into a composition. But then it comes to, you know, I don't just want to put some flowers in the foreground, aside from the fact that, I mean, mostly I don't want to do that because I don't want to focus stack flowers, because that's a nightmare. But what I've been wanting to do is I think it's pink granite. Yeah, I think pink granite is the type of rock that is well known, or that's quite iconic to this location. So ideally, I get this massive view that is iconic on the one hand, and combine that with a foreground element that adds to that in a similarly iconic way. So I've been looking around, and there's a bunch of ridges that look really interesting, but I found one that I'm standing on right now. And what's great about that is it's a bunch of lines that all kind of lead into the same point. It's almost like a knot starting to form in there. And yeah, so I figured that's a great one to use as a foreground. Admittedly, this isn't the first time that I've discovered this spot. I was here a couple of months ago looking around and found it, and pretty much on the same day saw that my good mate and other local and very, very, very talented photographer, Tim Grimsey, had found that already and had taken a picture of it. So I feel a bit like a jerk for taking this shot as well, but I'm sure he'll forgive me. I'll link to his channel, his Instagram account up there, or down there, or wherever. But yeah, I'm going to show you this landscape. I'm going to show you how it can feel a little bit overwhelming to find a kind of harmonious element in there that works within your composition as a foreground. And then I'm going to show you the one that I'll shoot here, And fingers crossed, we'll get some light in about 10 minutes. And then I'll take you through how I capture that shot. Yeah, let's get stuck in. Okay, so, you know, look at all this. There is so much potential there, right? I mean, it's boulders all over the place. You know, there is potential for, you know, a foreground left, right, and center. We've got these kind of flowers, the little pink ones, the little white ones there. Got these bushes, I don't find those very interesting. Okay, and so while all of those little flowers and those bushes and all that is nice, as I said, for me it's important to capture something that combines iconic parts of, you know, both the far distant picture and the closer part of the photograph. And the ridgeline that I found here is facing towards, not ridgeline, but you know, the little, whatever you want to call them, little cracks in the ground. They're facing towards the sun, which means during sunset, sun is about to poke out. It's going to light all that up wonderfully and just add that wonderful soft quality to the light on our foreground, which could be incredible. But let me show you what that foreground is going to be. It's this right here. So it might not look like much to the, you know, if you're just walking by. But what we have here is just all of these nice ridges that kind of run together in one spot here. And we're shooting this on 28 mils at the moment, but I'll put the wide angle on and you'll see how it accentuates the shape. So I'm using these rocks now in my foreground, and I've got a composition lined up. So let me talk you through how I thought about this comp. So you'll see that the tripod, rather than being close to the ground this time, I've actually got it standing quite high. And that's because this foreground curves downwards. So if I go too low, the actual lines disappear. But if I go nice and high, or relatively high, they kind of curve down into the scene. And I get the feeling that this is about as good as the light's going to get, because there's another big bank of clouds. So what I'll do really quickly now is just give us a little focus stack. So you'll see how these lines are kind of converging into the scene. And I do think it kind of operates like a leading line. So we're almost lining up this curve with Wineglass Bay here. And from here, I'm shooting at f16. Oh, you know what? I'm actually going to shoot this at f13 because I'm going to focus stack it anyway. And the way we're doing that is simply by focusing on the closest element to the foreground, or to us, going into the right corner, doing that. Then I think the middle, might not need it, but let's do it. Don't want to miss it later. And from here, work our way into the middle of the scene. Yep, here we go. Nice thing here is we won't have to exposure blend, because you can see in our histogram, we're not losing any highlight details, which means from here I can focus on the background and be done with it. And that's it. Yeah, that's all it took. Quite easy, and I think I said that in my last video. Bloody love it when I only need a focus stack at most. I'm not even quite sure. I think I'll need it here, but just to be safe, I always capture it. Annoyingly, there's an extra bank of clouds and I'm not going to get any more light. And all this beautiful, high, wispy stuff up there is not going to light up. But you know, that's how it goes sometimes. It's still nice up here. There's no one else around. I've got this entire space for myself, which is amazing. And yeah, with that, that's it. I'll put up the shot for you now. I hope you like it. If you do, let me know. Thanks for being here and watching my channel. I wish this would have been a more exciting video, but you know what? You can't have them all. Yeah, if you like my channel, you know the drill. If you enjoy the video, hit like. If you want to see more of my content, subscribe to the channel. And until then, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.